Let's work through a word problem involving forces. Here's the scenario. Hudson's dogs are out of control. They pull on their leashes, which are in Hudson's hand, with the magnitude and direction shown below. What magnitude and direction of force must Hudson exert so that no one moves? And we're going to assume all vectors lie in the horizontal plane, or in other words, we're only going to deal with two-dimensional movement. So out to the side here, we have a diagram, and we see Hudson's hand here, and then two force vectors, which represent the forces of the dogs pulling against his hand. And we're given the magnitude and the direction by an angle of each of those forces. So if we look at this purple vector here, over to the right, this force has a magnitude of 110 pounds. So a pound is a common unit the force is given in. And then it's at an angle of 45 degrees above this horizontal here. Okay. And now then we have the second force, which I've labeled F2, and its magnitude is 75 degrees, and its direction is 60 degrees but above this left horizontal as shown by the angle. So what we want to do is we want to figure out once again what force vector Hudson must exert so that no one moves. Now for no one to move, okay, that implies that the system is in what we call equilibrium. Okay, now for that to happen, force 1 plus force 2 plus what I'm going to call force H, which is just the force that Hudson is exerting, these must equal 0. These force vectors must equal 0 for no one to move. Okay, so we know F1 and F2. Sort of. We haven't really found their components yet, but we'll do that. So we know F1 and F2, so we'll be able to solve for FH, and that's our goal. But like I just said, to do that, we need to know a little bit more about F1 and F2, and specifically, we need to kind of resolve them into their components. So let's start with F1, and we are going to figure out what the X and Y components of F1 are. So it's usually pretty simple to resolve a force into its x and y components using an angle. So for example, for force 1, the x component is going to be 110, which is the magnitude of the force, times cosine of 45. Okay, cosine because I'm on the adjacent side of this angle. Okay, now similarly, the y component of this force is going to be 110 times sine of 45. Okay, and then we can do the same thing with the force vector F2 as well. So in this case, the x component of F2 is going to be negative, right, because it is pointing in the negative x direction. So negative 75 cosine of 60, and then the y component is still positive, it's still pointing up, so that's going to be 75 sine of 60 degrees. Okay, so now that we have these, we can set up this relationship here. Okay, so F1, if I want to write that as components, is going to be 110 cosine 45, comma 110 sine of 45, and then plus F2, which would be negative 75 cosine 60, plus 75 sine of 60, and then plus this unknown force, we want that to equal 0. Now you can put these values in your calculator, and you may be able to get an exact value. I've done approximations here, so I'll go ahead and give you those approximations. Exact values are generally better, though. But here's some approximations. These would be in units of pounds. So that's for F1. And then for F2, we have negative 37.5 in the x direction, 64.95 in the y direction, plus fh equals 0. Now I can actually add these first two vectors, right? Okay, and if I do that, I get 40.28 comma 142.73 plus Hudson's force equals 0. Well, then I can see what Hudson's force is going to need to be, right? It's going to need to be, and by the way, let me just make sure it's clear. This is the 0 vector. These are all vectors. FH, then, the force of Hudson, is just going to have to be the negatives. Negative 40.28, negative 142.73. Okay, so we've got the vector, but we want to find its magnitude and then its direction as an angle. So let's find its magnitude first. That's probably the easier thing to do. So the magnitude, we're just going to find like we usually would, the square root of the squares. So square root of negative 40.28 squared plus negative 142.73 squared. If you work that out, you should get 148.3 approximately. Okay, so that gives us the magnitude. Now to find the angle, let's go ahead and set up a triangle. Now if I scroll back up here, maybe it'd be helpful just to get a sense of the general direction this vector is pointing. Let's see, negative 40 in the x direction, 142 in the y. I don't have any tick marks on here, so it's hard to be exact. But let's see, probably somewhere generally in this direction is going to be our force that he needs to exert. So let's set up a triangle with that to find the angle more exactly. So this is going to be the force, and its magnitude is 148.3, okay? And we know that the x component is 40.28, and that the y component is 142.73. Okay, so then knowing those sides of the triangle, and this is a right triangle, I can calculate this angle theta. Okay, now you could use sine, cosine, or tangent. I'm going to use tangent. So tangent of theta is opposite, 142.73 over adjacent, 40.28. So then the inverse tangent or arctangent of this quotient will give us theta. And if you actually work that out, you should get that theta is approximately 74.24 degrees. Okay, now we know all the information we need. One of the issues often is finding the right way to describe these angles, and there's several ways you can do this. So let's go ahead and start writing our answer here. So Hudson must pull with 148.3. That was the magnitude, if you remember. We found the magnitude of his force to be 148.3. So pounds of force. Okay, and now we need to say something about the direction. And there's kind of two ways you could do this. One way that makes sense, so this 74.24 angle, and my picture is really cluttered here, but that's this angle here, right, that I'm just drawing in green. That's the angle we're thinking about. So one thing you could say is you could say about 74 degrees south of west. And that's maybe a little bit weird because we haven't really talked about directions in this story yet, but people would know what you meant. Okay? So one way we could say it is then 74.24 degrees south of west. Okay? Now, another way to say it is there's a convention, okay, that says for vectors, you describe them by taking the angle counterclockwise from the positive x-axis. So the angle I'm showing in red here. Okay, so that's kind of a standard convention. So if I did that, then that would that red angle would be 180 degrees plus my 74 degrees. So then we could say, another thing we could say is just at 254.24 degrees. And that 254 comes from 180 degrees plus 74.24 degrees. So I think either of those conventions that you use, you would be understood. So you can kind of choose which best fits the problem you're working on. But anyway, hopefully this gives you a sense of how to work through these force problems and resolve forces into their components.